Prime Minister Anthony Albanese will today promise Australians that the Voice to Parliament referendum will take place this year. It follows mounting pressure on the PM by those opposed to the constitutional change and a slip in support in recent polls. He'll deliver a speech at the Garma Festival today, Australia's largest Indigenous gathering in Arnhem Land in the Northern Territory. And this morning, Prime Minister Anthony Albanese will be live on Weekend Today, just after 8:30. The Prime Minister will today deliver a rallying call to Australians undecided about The Voice, urging them to vote to end the cycle of disadvantage for First Nations people. Live now to politics reporter Eliza Edwards in Arnhem Land. Good morning to you, Eliza. The PM is rejecting calls to delay this referendum.
That's right, Jane. Because there has been a slide in support for The Voice in the polls, some in the Yes camp have questioned whether the national vote should be delayed. But in his speech at Garma Festival today, the Prime Minister will emphatically reject that push, claiming kicking the can down the road would be to deny the urgency of this change. The Prime Minister will concede success at the upcoming referendum isn't guaranteed, but he says that's not a reason to change course when Indigenous Australians have been clear they want a voice to Parliament rather than, quote, sympathy or symbolism. In just a couple of months, all Australians will vote on this proposed change to the Constitution on whether to recognise First Nations people and establish an advisory body to represent them. The PM says a no vote would guarantee more of the same disadvantage. Jane?
Australia's largest Indigenous festival, Garma, is today underway in the Top End with the Voice to Parliament at the heart of the gathering.
Prime Minister Anthony Albanese is there for us. He joins us now from Arnhem Land in the Northern Territory. PM, good morning to you. Thanks for being with us on Weekend Today. What message are you hoping to get across to Australians this weekend?
That we have an opportunity to do something very good for the country. Indigenous Australians have asked for recognition, and they've asked for it in the form of a voice to Parliament. And there will be a referendum in the last quarter of this year. This is an opportunity to do just two simple things. One, to recognise Indigenous Australians, but secondly, to listen to them in order to achieve better results. And that is the beauty of the Uluru Statement from the Heart. It's a wonderful piece of writing where Indigenous Australians came together in 2017 to make this generous request, gracious request, to walk together towards reconciliation. But it also provides us with a path of how to get there as well. Because we know in life, our own experience knows, tells you that if you're going to make a decision that has an impact on someone else, listen to them, ask them what their views are. And that simply is what a voice is, an advisory body to government and parliament in order to achieve better results, because we know that the programs that have really worked, whether they're community health, Indigenous ranges, whether it be justice reinvestment programs, the programs that have made a positive difference are ones that have come from Indigenous Australians.
So it's been a year since you announced the wording that you wanted for the Constitution. When will you actually set the date for the referendum? Is it going to be on October 14?
Well, it will be sometime after the grand finals are held at the end of September. I'll be announcing that in coming weeks, what the date is, continuing to consult with people and continuing to make sure with the Australian Electoral Commission that processes can be in place and that it doesn't clash with other major events. But I said a year ago, I set out a timetable, and we've fulfilled that timetable by having the legislation passed in June after a parliamentary committee looked at the detail of the wording. So there were some revisions to the wording that I proposed, the draft at Garma last year, but it will be held in the last quarter of this year.
Prime Minister, I know this has become a deeply personal, a deeply emotional campaign for you. People sitting at home right now who've seen this slogan, if you don't know, vote no. Why should they be ignoring that?
Because if you vote no, you'll get more of the same. And we know that there's currently an 8-year life expectancy gap between Indigenous and non-Indigenous Australia. I think Australians will ask themselves, How would I feel if it was the case that if I had a daughter in childbirth, she was more likely to have issues if she was Indigenous than if she was non-Indigenous? If I had a son, a teenage son, was more likely to go to jail than to go to university? These are the sort of issues that we need to deal with. And here at Garma, with the community of the Yolngu people, we see how programs can work with that Indigenous empowerment. We're seeing better education outcomes. We're seeing children going to school and staying at school and getting qualifications. We're seeing better health outcomes. We're seeing better housing outcomes in this local community as well. And we're seeing through, for example, the bilingual school here, young Indigenous kids being taught in two languages. And what we need to do for Indigenous communities in areas like this is to walk in two worlds, but we can strengthen both of us. This is something we can do out of respect for Indigenous Australians, but it's something that will lift all Australians up as well when we're getting better outcomes, when we're not having these big gaps.
I don't think there's any argument that we need these better outcomes. But people are concerned about why they need to change the constitution to get those outcomes. The polls are showing that support for the voice is sliding. What are you planning to do differently from here on now so that people do start to come onto your side of things?
I believe very firmly that when people focus on what the question is, that's before the Australian people, which is a simple one. Every founding document of every former colony in the world recognises their first peoples, except one, Australia. New Zealand did it in the 19th century. Canada did it in the 20th century. Sweden and the Scandinavian countries did it a long time ago. When we look at all of the former colonies, there's only one that stands out as not giving acknowledgement to First Peoples. And that is all it does, is recognise Indigenous Australians in our nation's founding document. This place wasn't empty in 1788. That's simply what constitutional recognition does. But it does it in a form that just says there should be an advisory body on matters that affect Indigenous Australians. And that advisory body won't have funding responsibilities, it won't run programs, it won't have a right of veto. It will simply have a voice. And then it will be up to government or parliament to listen to that voice. But we know that when we listen to people about matters that directly affect them, you then lead to getting better results.